Narinder, Kaur, Blimey, and we are definitely bringing the Kaur into the Blimey today because I'm not in the kitchen, I'm in the bedroom because we're doing a makeup tutorial or a makeover. We are going from drab to fab.
So for today's Valentine's makeup tutorial, we will be using all these products.
So when I'm doing my makeup for a night out, I will lay all my makeup out in various sections. I will have all my eyeshadows over here. I will put concealers and foundations and contouring over here. Brushes to one side, mascaras, eyeliners to another side. And we've got, I always have cotton wool and some eye makeup remover for any mistakes and just to wipe up stuff. So I've washed and cleansed and moisturised my face. I don't put a heavy moisturiser on when I'm going to do makeup because a heavy moisturiser will have oils in it and your makeup will just come off. So I always put a light moisturiser on and I never put it on the nose area because I've got the T-zone, so it's quite oily here. I'll never put moisturiser there because makeup will just come off. We're going to start with eyes and we're going to do a smoky grey eye. There's various types of smoky. There's smoky brown, smoky plum, smoky peaches. We're going to do smoky greys. And I will start with my concealer. I'll put concealer all over my eye. And I actually go a bit lighter, as you do with concealer under there, you go a bit lighter, I'll put light all over, because we're gonna cover it with greys anyway. And I love using my sponges. I never use brushes, other than for contouring, but for my eye makeup, I'll use brushes. So, just put it all over the eye, over the brow. It's looking very white, you're probably thinking, oh my God, but remember, contouring, we're gonna put greys over the top, over the brow. I never do my foundation and concealer before my eye makeup because my shadows tend to fall and I end up having to wipe it away. So I would only cover the eye area like a little eye mask and that's how we begin with the eyeshadow. We're gonna be doing the charcoal smoky look, the greys. It's a signature look and it's one that I've done for years. Everyone is familiar with the Naked Urban Decay range. It's very popular, it's a great eyeshadow, brilliant pigmentation. But when you're going for the grey charcoal smoky look, I even use the cheaper ranges. I've used Rimmel, Bougie, any of the greys will do, they do the job. But let's start with this one. And as you can see, I layer and layer and layer. So let's start with the lighter one first. And we're just gonna cover up to, we're gonna cover the eyelid there, just to the middle brow bone there. And you've got to just sweep and blend. It's like a moon, like a half a moon shape, like a crescent. And you're not gonna go all the way over there, just a little bit over. And let's do the other side. It might look, what I'm gonna be doing is showing you what I do is, I'll put it all on rough first, and then we're gonna blend, blend, blend. Like half a moon shape up to the, that is your brow bone there, there. That's the middle there. And so we're going up to there. Right, and now we're gonna get a more rounded brush. So we've got the charcoal gray up to the brow bone, and now we wanna put some color just there, not your white, you can't put your white there because it'll just look gray and white. We need to lift it with a lighter color. I'm gonna go for a plum, and this is a Bougie Rose Vintage, and I'm gonna use the rounded, a very rounded brush. Remember the other time for the gray, I just had this is the number 2 from the Boots range. It's a flatter one, it's a flat rounded brush. This is the rounded brush. And I love this one because this is the one I blend, blend, blend. So I'm gonna put the darker one on there and I'm just gonna put it over the grey. And as you can see, it's lifted. And you just put it right on the crease. So it's gone over the grey a bit, but not all the way up to your brow bone there. It's just on the crease. Blend it in the corner all the way across. And you go kind of over the grey. So remember it was a bit messy? It's all looking a bit tidier now because we're blending the grey and the rose together, or plum. As you can see, that's that's done there. We're now gonna put that highlighter in the top end of the brow bone. So we've done the grey, we've done the plum to lift the crease, and now we're gonna do the brow bone. We're gonna highlight that area. What I'm gonna use is the MAC Nylon. This is like what every makeup artist uses. It's just like magic. It's like beautiful white dust there. Then you just put a little bit. What I used to do is, I'll show you what not to do. I used to put loads there, as you can see, and on photographs, especially your selfies, it looks at that, it looks terrible. You can make mistakes because it's so easy, but that's a mistake. But you don't need to get your eye makeup removed and put it on there. You just get that one again and go over your mistake. I've just put a bit more of the plum in the crease over the white, and we'll do the same there. Blend, blend, blend. So, as you can see, we've done the charcoal, we've done the plum, and we've done the lighter one in the brow bone. We're gonna go back to the Naked palette. We started with the lighter gray, the gunmetal. We're now gonna go to crepe, because we're gonna now start layering. And we're just gonna gently layer some dark over there. And just going like a half moon crescent. Don't go up to the crease, because we've got our plum there. And then the same, a little dab. You don't need to be, you know, this, I've had this like over a year. Just need a little dab. And if you get too much on there, you just, so that it's not falling over your face. But it doesn't matter if it does fall over your face, because remember, we haven't even put our foundation on. So we're gonna leave the eyeshadows for now, and we're gonna go to the liquid liner. Brush is just done so easily. You do have to have a steady hand. So we're gonna start with the corner of the eye, and we're gonna get the tip, but not just the tip. Don't do it like that. That would never work, it's gotta be at a slant. And that seems a little bit, we're gonna go over it. As you know with me, we're gonna layer, layer, layer. Let's go to the other side. We're gonna be so slow and gentle. And again, we're gonna go back to this one and layer over that again. As you can see, we've done the liquid eyeliner from the corner to just there. Now, this is how I do my winged out look. I get the skin and I kind of pull it up. You don't wanna pull it down because you don't want your eyeliner going down, you wanna go up, because that will lift the eye up. So I kind of get the skin there and I push it back, and I get my brush, and I'm looking, it's quite difficult, but I'm looking that way, and I just gently. Now, that looks a bit thick and look, it's gone down, but I'm gonna show you with the brush, with the makeup brush, what we're gonna do. We get that, and then while it's still wet, you just wing it up, wing it up. And that, again, you might think that looks wrong, you're gonna brush that off, and wing that again. Take some off the top, take it off. So it's sweep, take off, sweep, take off. But then you go thicker there, and then back there. And let's do the other side. So we've just finished winging out the liquid liner with the sponge, and I'm gonna go back to my Naked palette, and I love this brush that you get with the Urban Decay Naked palette. It's a sharp-ended, rounded brush, and you just get the tip, literally the tip, and sweep it into the gunmetal, using literally the tip and not the slanted side. I pull the skin again, and gently wing it out again. So as you can see, the wings, now you have a look. My son just said in the background, you look like a dragon. It does look like a dragon for now, but when it all comes together, you'll see what I mean. We're gonna go back, because what I do is I'll have a look and think, oh my God, the blending doesn't look right. So I'll get my rounded brush again and blend it again. I'll go back to the eyeshadow, back to the crease, and blend in again. I'm gonna get the crepe again onto a pointed, it's actually a lip brush, but I think it's fabulous for just getting in to that crease and drawing a line. Join it to the liquid liner there. And you go that way. You don't want to go downwards. Again, that will droop your eyes, and we want to lift our eyes. So you go back to the rounded brush and just gently soften it. Soften that all out. And the same with the other side. So we put the crepe into the, like a triangle in the corner there. Triangle it into there. And we're just gonna get the rounded ended brush again, and we're just gonna blend it all in. We don't want severe lines. Severe lines is a bit tranified, and I used to do that, but now I kind of just soften out all the lines. We wanna soften everything out. Soften that out, that's done. Let's get our sponge again, my lovely sponge that I love to just lift it up again. So we're leaving the eyeshadows for now. We've done the liquid liner, we've lifted it up, and now we're going to the brow game. Apparently it's all about the brows, and it really is. I've looked back at photographs and thought, where are my eyebrows? And when your eyebrows aren't defined, it's so aging. And when the eyebrows are defined correctly, not when they're overdone, when you've done it correctly, it's so de-aging. And as you can see, I've actually got alopecia in one of my eyebrows there. I'm missing a big chunk, I don't know how, but we're gonna fill this in. And I use the MAC Fluid Line in Dip Down. It's a dark chocolate brown. I use the angled brush, like that. And so gently, you just need a little bit on there, just a tiny dab, gently, like so gently, like literally just dabbing it on, but fluidly, very gently and in upward strokes, like windswept. So, we're gonna fill in and lift up. And where you don't have eyebrow, where there's no hair, do longer sweeps. It really is intricate job. It's so delicate. And again, remember what I said, if you make a mistake, you can swipe it off and wind sweep it this way. Now I'm almost scared of putting too much on, so then I'll start with the least amount. And when I think I've got the shape right, and I think that shape's okay, I'll put a little bit more on, just a little bit. And again, on the inner corners, sweep up, and as you can see, I'm going darker. And you don't want to go down, you're going to droop your eye down, you want to go up. So keep your eyebrows, don't go all the way down. Okay, that's one done. Let's go to the other side. See, I'm not going to, you know, take all my makeup off, I'm just going to use my finger. Take it off there. Makeup isn't permanent. You don't have to take everything off, you just get your finger, get a sponge, get a tissue, cotton wool, and just gently take it off. It just lifts. That now has set off my charcoal look. We're now gonna do the mascara. I'm not fussed about any mascara. I use, you know, the Rimmel ones. I've got the Yves Saint Laurent, this is Christian Dior. I don't find they're all a much for muchness for me. As long as it gives that depth, we're gonna do the Christian Dior one. And you start right from the bottom, almost you're looking down. So I'm looking at you now, but I will be looking down and get right into the lower lashes and sweep up. So now I'm gonna put foundation on the rest of the face. So we're just gonna get our sponge, our cotton wool ball, and we're just gonna, you don't necessarily need, I mean, sometimes if there's loads falling, I will use my eye makeup remover. And I'll just gently, but there's not actually a lot of falling to this. We're just going to clean that up. Now, I'm obsessed at the moment with my Bare Skin Bare Minerals one. I love this one. It's like a serum one. It just brightens up my skin. It really is a fabulous foundation. Now, if you see, that's a nice, it's a beautiful serum foundation. And I'll even go into the concealer a bit just to blend it in. And with the brush, just keep blending it and putting it on. And put it up to wing it out again. Keep winging out this look. I even go into the hairline there as well. Because the worst thing is having a line of circular foundation. So it's like a mask. You want it so it's flawless. Yes, it's not for a night of passion. But he's not going to notice with the lights off. Once the lights are off, the candles are on. Oh God, he won't notice a thing. I know some people do prefer using the brush, but I find the brush is what we've been using for contouring. So, right, we've covered all of that up. Now that we've covered our foundation, we've got the top half of our eyes, we're now going to do the eyeliner, ready for the end piece of the eye makeup. And I'm going to put on black on the inner. So you get right in. This is what I'm using. It's called Queen Attitude. I think it's from a brow. I'll find out and I'll write it in the description box below. It's Queen Attitude and it's a black. I mean, it's called Gajal eyeliner, and it's what actually Indian women used to use in India. It's such a strong pigmentation. And you go right into your eye, close your eye, over it, and get the upper eyelid as well. And get right into the corner. And as you can see, the blackness of that has just now pulled that out. So there, that's not finished, we have to blend that in now as well. Now for the bottom, I'm gonna go for a dark brown, and I'm loving
this Rock and Cole Charlotte Tilbury eyeliner. It's an iconic liquid eye pencil, but it's not liquid actually, it's just, it gives such a beautiful pigmentation for the bottom. So we're gonna, again, hold your eye up, get your eyeliner, and for the bottom there, so we're not going in and out, we've done the black on the inside, just on the bottom eyelid, just move my hair out, we're gonna just put some dark brown on the bottom. Might think it looks a bit thick, and it is, but I do love a thick liquid liner. I think that's what gives you that, the Arabic eyes, and it lifts. So I've gone from looking tired, and all of a sudden I look, it's made my eyes look awake. We want to soften out what we put there, so soften that out. And if it's not clean enough, again, get the corner of your sponge, wipe that. So, as you can see, we winged it out on that side, and we winged it out on this side. Now, all the eyes are done. We're not even gonna bother with lashes. We'll do that on another tutorial. And we're now gonna, my face is just round at the moment. We're gonna get some, the very important cheekbones. The Dallas color in Benefits, it's the brushes like this, and it's perfect. And what you do is you almost suck in your cheeks, and where the line is, where the shadow is, you get this flat-ended blusher brush and dab a little bit. Remember, never put a load on. You just need to dab it a little bit, even shake some off. As you can see, when I tap it, some comes off. And then again, pucker up your lips. The line's already there, and you're just following the line that's there. You can't just do this and put it on. You'll be putting it on wrong. You put it on too high, too low. If you do it this way, and then I even put it on the chin to soften up the chin, on the jawline to soften that out. And then I get your normal, I get the normal blusher brush, and then I'll go to a bronzer. I actually got this from, you know them pharmacy stores, it's called Technic, and I think it was like £1.50. And you know, is it Bobbi Brown doing expensive from Body Shop? This was like £1.50. Get your normal blusher brush, dab some on there, and then the lines that we've done there, you blend it to the top of half like that. You get your powder brush. We're almost finished. I've got this is the Laura Mercier translucent, any translucent, I'm not fussed about powders. And get your powder on. This is the Ben Nye one in Sunset. And you just pencil that in. This is my little secret I'm letting you into, and getting those kissable big lips. Now, I've been blessed with quite a good lip shade, but this Smashbox Photo Op, it's actually an under eye brightener, but I've never used it for the under eye brightener because I think it just emphasizes my dark circles. But I get it into the Cupid's Bow, paint it on there, and I leave the house. No, I don't. I'm now going to get my sponge, my good old sponge, and just tap it in. So as you can see, it's kind of swollen. It's giving me that swollen look, as if I've been kissed. And look, it's made my lips look instantly bigger.
How many men do you kiss on a night out, Narinder?
I used to kiss about 8 men a night. And then you just get your red lipstick. I think for my colour, for Asian colour, I think Lancome do the best red lipsticks. The sharpness of your lip, of your lipstick should be your lip liner. Fill it in. Who cares if it goes over a bit? Because any mistakes, you just get the corners of your brush and soften it out. It's all about putting your lips together, and even use your fingers. Just get your little finger and go into that Cupid's bow. Again, pucker up. So there you go. We've gone from drab to fab, from tired to sassy, and we're gonna get on that red hot number. See you in a moment. So we've got on our red hot makeup, red hot dress, and I'm ready for my red hot date for Valentine's. If you like the makeup tutorial, please click subscribe. It's just down there. Click subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Mwah.